Hey everybody, Bob Babbitt here. Day three of Breakfast with Bob from beautiful New York City. We are presented by Polar, sponsored by UCAN and Babbittville Radio. Our next guest, Seth James DeMoor, just ran Amsterdam last week. Huge guy on YouTube. I am a big fan. Seth, thank you so much for taking time, man.
Thank you, Bob, for having me. And I just got in yesterday from Colorado, and here we are ready to rock the five boroughs of New York City. So,
Amsterdam last week.
Two weeks ago. Yep.
And now this, recovery and...
You know, it took about 8 days for the soreness to go away.
Yeah.
I know my legs are not completely fresh, but I'm hoping that the effort in Amsterdam, as far as aerobically,
yes,
that it maybe gives me a little bit of a boost here through the five boroughs. But
and what'd you run in Amsterdam?
Well, I ran 2:23:37,
wow,
but I came through the halfway a little hot in 106:53.
Oh, you came in the half? Most people would go 106. I'm dropping the mic. That's my half marathon
right,
PR.
That yeah. was my half marathon PR.
Oh, was
PR.
It really?
It was. So I went out a little too fast, learned my lesson, and but I'm ready to ease it back quite a bit in New York tomorrow.
What are you looking for, time?
Well, I'm going to go out in 5:20s.
Okay.
Which puts you at 2:19, 2:20 pace. But obviously, there's more elevation gain here in New York compared to Amsterdam. But I'm going to really... I'm going to write patience on my wrist just to be patient
exactly.
in this race, yeah.
So going from being a high school and collegiate runner
yeah.
to deciding, hey, I got to create my own YouTube channel. What
yeah.
the hell? Why
uh-huh.
not?
Uh-huh.
And you're a father of three,
uh-huh.
and your little guys are in a lot of the videos. You've got your studio.
That's right.
So did it start with testing product first, or what?
You know, it started actually more as a daily life vlog.
Right.
And maybe once a month I would incorporate running into the vlog. But then I realized, wait a minute, I love running a lot.
Right.
I should put it into the vlog more and more. And then eventually,
yeah,
once
yeah.
that happened, runners
found
started
it.
To find it and find it. And that
yeah.
was about a year ago when it really went all into running.
So when you were doing the vlog before,
yeah.
it was just about being a parent and
you know,
lifetime?
It was,
or just,
yeah, it was like, you know,
just, yeah.
drinking a lot of coffee, you
yes.
know, making my coffee. You know how I do that in the vlog? And taking care of the house and travel vlogs and, yeah, some family vlogs. And at the end of the day, and I was training pretty seriously, but nothing like the past year.
Right.
And then eventually shoes started arriving at my door, and I was like, oh, maybe I should start testing these
yes.
and then giving my thoughts and opinions on these running shoes and which ones are working, which ones are not. And eventually, that helped a lot as well. So
as a guy who's testing different shoes, and obviously you're an elite runner, you're
yeah.
running in the 220s, elite runner. If a shoe isn't quite right, it's you're going to notice it more than most of us who are sort of
yeah.
slogging along.
Sure.
What have you learned? Are you impressed with the change? Because people are coming out with the new shoes, like, four times a year. They're changing the shoes constantly.
Yeah, yeah.
What are your thoughts in terms of, is there too much change going on? Mm. Are there enough improvements going on?
Mm-hmm. I think every company is raising, I think, you know, like Nike and Hoka.
Yes.
I think they're starting, and I think eventually Adidas And New Balance this year has really
right.
made a good push.
They really have.
So I think the bar, if everyone, the bar is being raised for everyone.
Yes.
By this innovation. Now there's a, you know, there's, I'd say there's needs to be a balance out there with how much innovation happens
right.
in shoes. But I've seen it, absolutely. But Hoka, New Balance, and of course Nike, those are the three that kind of jump out at me right now that are really pushing the bar.
So is the goal for you to get to the, obviously you're going to the trials.
Yes, so I am trying to qualify, well, I'm not there yet. So
no, you got to get that A.
I need a 2:19.
Is that the A?
That's the B.
Okay.
Just to get into, yeah, just to get to Atlanta, that's the goal, the Olympic trials qualifying time.
Right.
So that was the goal in Amsterdam. And it, so I'm an ultra runner, trail runner,
right.
who's converted, I'm converting to the road marathons. So I've learned a lot. I learned a lot in Amsterdam. I'll just put it that way.
So was that one of your first road marathons?
Yes, yes.
Wow. And
I'll just say it was my first road marathon.
What's fascinating is most guys go 5K, 10K, half marathon, full, right? They go that way. So you're going sort of the opposite.
It's so, isn't that crazy? It's
yeah,
kind of crazy.
Hard to go from so long to even shorter and try to go and add speed.
Yeah. And I still have some speed in there, thankfully.
Obviously.
But it's, I think the endurance is there.
No question.
And but it's the experience. I just, reining it in the first, you know, 15, 18 miles, I got a little too excited chasing a pack in Amsterdam and learned my lesson. But, yeah, it was my first marathon out there.
So why not do another one 2 weeks later? What
right?
the hell?
Yeah, why not? Why not?
I mean,
yeah.
You're there.
Jump, yeah, come on. Got the fitness. And as long as these legs can withstand the ups and downs of the bridges, we'll see. Yeah.
So when you're doing your show,
yeah,
do you know before you post something, oh, this is a great episode, people are going to like it? Or are you as surprised as I am which ones? You know, I mean, sometimes you're like, oh my God, that was an amazing interview, and it gets crickets. And then another one where you're like, and then it does great.
Sometimes there are surprises, yeah. But I've been doing a daily vlog. So it's a daily vlog, Seth DeMoor. It will, like, I've gotten to the, for 3 years now.
Oh, 3 years. Okay.
So I actually,
you've got a loyal following.
I really do know, like, okay, I know this one's going to do well.
Yes.
Just based on the content, based on the title,
right.
The thumbnail, all that stuff.
Do you do more, do you try to do product stuff in every one? Or is
no.
that just
no,
whenever maybe, you feel like it?
Yeah. Whenever I believe in a product, maybe.
Yes.
Twice a week, something will pop in. I don't
okay.
know. Yeah, two or three times a week.
Is
yeah.
that, I mean, we go and we'll do a bunch of interviews over yeah. like a week or two.
Yeah.
I don't do anything daily.
Sure,
I go
sure.
out of my mind.
Yeah.
How do you maintain that? Because you're doing your own editing and everything too, right?
I am. I mean, at the end of the day, you have to love it.
Right.
You know, the whole creative process.
Yes.
And I do love it. It is hard at times, of course, tiring. But I think, you know, even I got my first video camera when I was in middle school.
I was going to say, so you've been doing this a while.
I've been doing this since I was, you know, for, God, 20 years.
Right.
By filming. And then editing for, you know, 15 years. So that's what I tell everyone. And it's just like running. Patience. Like, you got to be patient with the creative process,
right.
with training for a marathon.
The fascinating part is this is such a great era to do this,
yeah.
right? Because
oh, yeah.
you have a built-in audience. It's not like back in the day where you'd make a video and make a VHS tape and try to get it out to people, or make a CD and try to... People instantaneously will follow you.
Yeah.
And you... How has the process for you changed over the last 3 years in terms of equipment?
Oh, wow. It's in terms of equipment, better
yeah.
audio equipment. I've learned my lesson to have lavalier mics.
Yes.
I have it on right now.
Good.
That's one thing. What else? I mean, I edit on a Mac,
right.
but you don't have to. But I like my Mac. It's fast. It's reliable. But at the end of the day, I also say, like, you can now film with your phone.
Yes.
And it's like
incredible,
it's pretty
quality.
Pretty high quality.
Yeah.
So you don't have to have the nicest equipment. It's like, I've learned, and you probably know too, it's like what's better is the story there. The story's the key.
Well, and that's what's so cool in this day and age. It's all about content.
Yeah.
It's all, when you have good content, you have compelling content.
Yeah.
You're doing product reviews. Your people are watching because they like seeing the interaction with you and your kids.
Yeah.
They like seeing you and your boys eating popcorn. And you have your beer stein with the tea in it.
Foam rolling all over the place.
Yeah.
And going to races.
Exactly.
Like the New York, like this guy in Amsterdam and Kipchoge, I'm sure you saw. So, yeah.
Pretty
yeah.
fun, huh?
Yeah, it is fun. It's... Yeah, we live in a good era.
Is it ever get old for you, knowing, oh, my God, I got to get up tomorrow and film something? And is this something you do full-time?
You know, it's becoming full-time very
yeah.
quickly. I mean, a year ago, I wouldn't be able to say that.
Right.
But it's becoming full-time, which I'm grateful for.
Yeah.
But there's more, like, okay, I'll tell. So, Bridget, my wife, true love, you've
yes.
been seen her in the vlog.
Yep.
I will wake up sometimes and I'll tell her... I'm going to film just a little easier today.
Right.
Where I just won't, you know, instead of 75 clips of filming, I'll film like 20 to 30. I'll just take the day, quote unquote,
a light day.
A light day. So there are moments where I'll be on, you know, where I'll just take the day a little easier. But
the other thing is when you sort of put your life out there.
Yeah.
Now people have expectations, right?
Sure.
Hey, we have one of the guys in triathlon, Lionel Sanders, and every time they post stuff, it's all, he's going.
Yeah.
Like, pushing 400 watts and going so hard all the time, right?
Yes.
You feel that, that, you know, if people are going to watch, they want to see me suffer. They want to see me really working hard.
Yeah, I mean, there are, yes, I'll be honest, there are moments where, you know, like hitting certain times in a workout.
Right.
Like I did a couple threshold runs leading up to Amsterdam, and I hit my times, but you're putting it out on the internet, and you know, people are there. Like even Amsterdam, it was tough because I didn't hit my 2:19 goal. But of course, you just have to have a positive attitude and keep pushing forward,
right,
no matter the outcome. But it is a little bit of pressure there.
So if you don't run 2:19 tomorrow, will you still go to the trial? I mean, could you run? You could run with the not the A and B. You just wouldn't go off with the elite guys. Could you go off with the?
No, you have to hit 2:19.
Okay. Oh wow!
Yeah,
okay. That's it.
Yep, that's it. So. We'll
tomorrow's
see.
It.
Well, do you have any more? There's other opportunities. Yeah,
because it's about what 13-14 weeks to end of February.
You know,
so you got a few more options.
I'm trying. If anyone has connections to the Houston Marathon or half marathon in January, that's the last opportunity.
That's the last
down
one.
In Houston. Yeah,
I think they might.
Right. Well, we'll see.
See if they would like.
I know we've got to pull some strings out there. So, yeah.
Love it. Hey, Seth, thanks so much for taking time. I love what you're doing. I love the blog. If people want to watch the blog, where do they go?
Yeah, so the vlog is Seth DeMoor, SethDemoor, or just type in Seth Runner or anything like that.
It'll come up into
YouTube. It'll come up.
Love it.
You'll see my green hat.
Thanks for joining
us. Thanks for having me.
Have a great one tomorrow.
Thank you. It's going to be fun.
All right. Seth J. DeMoor has been our guest. Hold on, everybody. We will be right back.